name is Tino Paha. I'm the Chief Marketing Officer.
My name is Juan Alonso. I'm the Chief Design Officer.
I'm Jordan Reyes. I'm the Chief Marketing Officer.
And my name is Michael Vasquez. I'm the Chief Design Officer.
Hello, I'm Joe Bravo, and I'm the Chief Operations Officer.
Hello, my name is Anika Chan. I'm the Chief Financial Officer.
Hello, I'm Bianca Rossi, and I'm the Chief Executive Officer.
And we're going.
It's so dark outside, I can't even see the rain. Maybe we should just go early today or not.
I have a solution for you guys. It's a basketball, it's a blonde, a dark basketball rim. It glows green, it's portable, and it's made of neoprene rubber.
Our primary target market, as you can see, are boys and girls ages 10 to 18. Our secondary target market are men and women, ages 19 and up, and it also makes a great gift. Our persona is Emily. She's an educator at Sequoia High School. She's a JV basketball player. As you can see, she practices basketball outside until nighttime. She appreciates the glory, she recommends our products.
So, two of our main competitors is Glow City and Negatives. So, Glow City, as you can see, costs $94.99, $95. And its weaknesses is, of course, it's too expensive. And it's only available online. And while the night group is not portable and only available online. And like two good things about them is how it comes in a set and it's a glowing basketball game. And so our room is portable, affordable, and fits onto any regulation room.
After survey, 50 people with 94% prefer the color green than any other color. 54% of people prefer to pay $10 rather than any other price. And 82% would like to buy a product.
We will be selling our product for $10 and we'll be donating complimentary rims to American Heart Association and Hoops for Heart. We'll be promoting our product by putting flags around the school campus, our Sequoia station, and our social media, which we have Instagram is Glow Scoring, and Facebook is Glow, and our Snapchat is Glow Scoring.
Our cloth consists of neoprene rubber, magnets, and glow dark spray paint, which comes out to be $2.17 to make 1 unit.
Our starter cost is $7.99 for 100 pack for business cards.
After a 3 month selling period, we plan to sell 36 units, and we have a minor mistake on our revenue total. It's not $450, it's $360. Our COGS will be $70.12, and our operating cost is $7.89, and our profit will be made after that, as you can see,
$260. Oh, we'll be asking for $190, $7.99 for 3 months of operating, 3 months of COGS is $78.12. Our revenue will be $450, and our breaking point is 19 lowers.
They don't want you to make the three, they don't want you to see the dark. Let's move to the door.
We will now take questions.
We shot a video on, and we posted it on our Instagram.
It's him shooting into our prototype.
Yeah.
I have a design question. Is the glowing part on the bottom, or is it on the top?
Right now it's on the top, but we're planning on making it around the rim so people can actually see it.
Okay. And how long does the glowing last for?
It recharges with light.
Yeah.
So.
But how long does it last at night?
At night?
It depends on how much it recharges. So maybe it should start.
So
when
we charge?
Yes.
And the paint is the one to recharge.
Yes.
How do you fix it up? I mean, you'd have to be pretty
people have rims that are retractable, so you can just retract it and then put it on. And we're planning to contact Parks and Rec to see if they can put it on the rims for other people.
So in the case that all of your marketing and social media presence, your product blows up and you guys are slammed and the manufacturing is crazy, what is your plan for either potential accessories to go with it, or do you think you'll stick to just this one?
Depending on how it goes, we might add other stuff. If we have more money, we could add like a glow-in-the-dark net. So yeah, depending on how it goes, we might add other stuff.
We have time for one more question.
I'm not a marketing person, but you had a student as the persona. Have you guys considered also including businesses as well? Like you talked about Parks and Recs. Did you guys include that analysis? So you presented one persona earlier, which was a student. Have you guys considered including another persona, like a business or like schools or other places that would maintain